So are you ready for Battle of the Saddle this year?
Yes, of course, I'm ready. I heard it's gonna be the best game.
Yeah, I know, I hope so. But anyways, welcome back, Miners, to a new episode of Ed Hews.
That's right, you guys, welcome back.
So are you a part of a green club?
No, what is it about?
Well, I don't know either, but let's check it out.
This week, Green Club put on a very successful Energy Conservation Week. We had various lunchtime activities throughout the week that symbolized various things that we can do to use other methods of energy or to conserve the energy that we're already using. Today, the teachers were challenged with having to try to paint what energy conservation means to them using food products instead of paint and only using their hands. So it's basically finger painting with food. And Mrs. Griffiths was our winner today, and all the teachers did a great job though, and it was awesome that they could all come out and participate. Green Club meets Tuesdays during lunch in Mr. Miller's room, which is room 361, and there's lots of opportunities for community service such as recycling that we do every week. So come join us.
So have you heard about the yellow ribbon that's going around school?
Yeah, I have actually. I hope that everyone that's going through any depression or suicide calls for support. You should be receiving them during homeroom.
Yeah, it's important to the people who have ever been depressed or thought about suicide. I seriously think that everyone should just be nice to each other.
Seriously, and definitely know that there is many support out there for you guys.
Well, here, let's check out the story.
Hey, Miners, Blake here. Every year, the Visalia Unified School District and the Parent Teacher Association provides yellow ribbon cards to all the high school and middle school students in the district. This is a suicide prevention program and is used in all 50 states and in 47 countries. If you are having thoughts of suicide, the yellow ribbon card can help you in two different ways. One is it gives you a 24-hour phone number in case you need to talk to someone. There is a local number and a national 800 number. The second is to assist you in asking for help, since sometimes you may need help, but it's hard to say the words. The yellow ribbon program has been in use since 1994 and has helped save many lives. This school year, El Diamante High School put the yellow ribbon card phone numbers and information on the back of every student ID card. Please keep your ID card with you at all times and take this program seriously. Other yellow ribbon cards will be available in the front offices if you would like any extra cards. If you're having a tough time in life and need help, reach out to your parents, teachers, friends, or other school staff, and remember that there are people who care about you. Have a great day, Miners.
Just remember to carry this card with you guys at all times. It's very helpful.
That Redwood game last week was just popping.
I know, it was. I love all the spirit we had.
Yeah, especially that it was a whiteout. That was like totally legit. But here, anyways, let's kick it to sports.
Hey, Miners, it's Saddle Week. Hope you're full of spirit. Let's see how cross country did last Wednesday for WIL with Brenner.
Hey, Miners. Cross country was at Mooney's Grove last Wednesday. Let's see how they did.
Last Wednesday, cross country was at Mooney's Grove for the second WYL cluster. Both boys and girls came out strong at their home course. In varsity boys, Central Section's fourth-ranked runner, Jacob Elvado, shined. He took first place, and after the race, he talked to us about his performance.
I think it was pretty good. Did what I wanted to do, went out fast, held on, and took it in towards the end for the win. I really want to be up there in state, like around top 10. So that's my goal this year.
Back to you, Emma.
Thanks, Brenner. Volleyball played Lemoore at LD last Thursday. Spencer, tell us how it went.
Hey, Miners. Varsity volleyball beat Lemoore last Thursday in three sets. Let's go check out some highlights.
Volleyball beat league rival Lemoore last Thursday on Halloween. The Miners improved their record to 27-2, staying undefeated in the league. After the game, sports caught up with Captain Lauren Torres for some thoughts.
It felt amazing to beat Lemoore. We've never beat Lemoore in three, so it was like a big accomplishment to beat them that quick. We were all just playing really intense. We were all on our game, and it was a good game, and I'm proud of everyone.
Make sure to go out to support volleyball this Thursday for the Battle of the Spandex right here at LD against Golden West. See you next week, Miners.
Thanks, Spencer. Football played Lemoore last Friday. Let's catch up with Adrian.
Hey, Miners. LD just won a nail biter, 27-21 here in Lemoore. Here's some highlights.
Let's go! Let's go!
Football was on the road last Friday at Lemoore as you look to clinch first place in the WYL. The Miners got off to a quick start with a 65-yard touchdown from Keelan Lyles, starting in place of injured running back D'Angelo Torres. The Miners took advantage of the passing game for one of the first times this year, with J.C. Robles throwing touchdowns to Adam Chavez, Joey Chica, and Nick Bigger. The Miners' defense shut down Lemoore's running back, Richard Doctor, one of the top running backs in the state, holding it to season-low 95 rushing yards. Late in the fourth quarter, the Miners marched down the field in a game-sealing drive, eating up 8 minutes of clock, capped off by Robles' 4th-and-1 QB sneak and a pass to Mitchell Boswell. After the game, we caught up with J.C. and Keelan for some thoughts.
I played pretty good. My O-line helped me out a lot.
I just got to lock up WYL now.
Feels good. Really good.
I told Coach Rogers, run the ball. I don't want to take a chance to throw the ball, throw an incomplete pass. He trusted me. He trusted Mitchell Boswell. And Mitchell Boswell went up and made a great play.
Next week, I don't even have to tell you guys. It's Saddle. Show Golden West what minor pride is. Back to you, Emma.
Thanks, Adrian. Let's pack the student section Friday for battle. See you next week, Miners.
Hey, Miners, Chef here. So rumor around campus is that there's a battle happening for something on a horse. I think it's called a paddle, or it's a saddle, I think. It doesn't sound right, though. Well, anyways, let me show you guys how to prepare for it. Yes. Step one, get yourself the right battle equipment. I don't think this is the right one. There we go. That seems about right for battle, right? I think. Step two, come eat healthy. None of the great battle winners have ever not eaten unhealthy food because they're slim and sexy. Step three, prepare your armor and your battle cry. Step four, train. Step seven. Wait, step with the number that's after the one I said before. Practice makes perfect.
Final step to prepare yourself for this glorious battle is to mentally prepare for all the blood that will be shed.
Do you even play football?
Football?
Do you know Battle of the Saddles football game, right?
What is that? What is football? I'm not catching your drift.
It's like brown ball. Yeah.
Oh. Never played it in my life. There's no guys riding horses with lances?
No. It's a ball. It's a football.
Okay.
That's it.
So it's like a bomb.
You know what? Good luck with this. I'm gonna let you just think about it.
Well, now that I'm aware that it's not an actual fight, which is not as cool, apparently it's a foots game, football. Just show up to the student section and show some school spirit. So I'll see you guys next time on the next how-to with a very confused Seth, because I'm still thinking about this. Can we fight Golden West like an actual battle? I think that'd be better, because then they'd just be gone after that. That way, we wouldn't have to worry about them losing to us every year, you know? Well, see you guys later.
Man, I hate that I never win when I post pictures on replay.
Me either. Dude, what's going on? Cassidy, I think there's a problem we need to fix.
Yeah, like for real, my pictures are fresh.
I don't think they're fresh enough for Cassidy.
Yeah, well here, let's check it out.
Hey Miners! Welcome back to the weekly replay road trip photo competition put on by Yearbook. To get this party started, the winner from your harvest theme is Brianna Terry. Congratulations, Brianna. Please dance your way over to Mr. Jirocking Room 603 to claim your prize. And now to unveil the top four from the Halloween theme. We have option A, option B, option C, and option D. Once again, that is A, B, C, and D. To vote, just go on the Replayed app and like the photo you want to win. finally, the theme for this week is hate. What are some of the things that you despise? Eating vegetables, doing homework, listening to Justin Bieber, taking pictures? Well, take one anyway and submit it by fifth period on Monday for a chance to be on Ed Hews, be in the yearbook, and receive either a $10 discount or a free protective cover along with extra autographed pages. Remember, minors, entering the contest is super easy. Just download the app, replay it, make an account for El Diamante High School, and please remember to put the theme in the caption. Well, enjoy posting your hate pics, and we'll see you all next time with your replay road trip update.
So what do you like about Battle for the Saddle?
Well, I love that everyone gets so excited and everyone gets so spirited. Yeah. I just love it.
I like how crazy the student section gets, though.
I know, it's amazing.
Yeah, well, let's check out what people around campus are saying what they like about Battle for the Saddle.
A freshman should expect for it to be like really loud, a lot of upperclassmen.
Get painted in the state tournament.
That's what you gotta do. Can expect a really good game. Possibility of a win. No, it's not a possibility. Just, you know, it's gonna be a definite win.
No. Win and destroy.
Yeah. We're gonna destroy.
No.
Eliminate.
Annihilate.
Don't not sit in the student section.
Yeah. Sit in the student section.
And stand up and yell.
Don't be quiet.
Freshmen should expect to see all the Golden West fans walk all the tears on the field.
We should not hackle the other players, like, or heckle them, because it's just heckle them because it's just not cool. That we should support our team.
This year we expect for Battle of the Saddle just to turn up. Just turn up all over the football field. Just turn up.
I just want to get my first touchdown.
Do not be stupid. Like, if we win. Do not go all crazy and start fights and stuff.
Stay classy, OB.
So do you know what's going around the world?
Well, I haven't been watching the news lately.
Nope. I heard that Bad Grandpa made over $32 million.
Wow.
And I still need to go see that movie.
I do too. Hey, we should go this weekend.
Totally. But anyways, let's check out Ed Hughes News.
All right, welcome everybody. This is Ed Hughes News. I want to welcome you guys, and some of you guys have heard, I'm not sure, but my homie Chris Brown, he's thrown in prison again for assault. He was simply taking a picture with his hyena, and some guy had the nerve to photobomb him. Out of self-defense, I mean, he had to beat the guy up. He had nothing else to do. I honestly believe that Chris Brown is the unluckiest person ever for getting arrested for self-defense twice. Have you ever woken up from a text that you don't remember sending? Well, you might be a victim of sleep texting. Surveys show that out of 300 students, 25 to 30% kids have texted while they were asleep. It's a reoccurring event that has affected many youngins, also known as teens, around the big blue marble. All right, well, I'll see you guys next time on Ed Hughes News.
Well, thank you guys so much for letting us know all the gossip going on.
Yes, thank you. Well, Absolute Miners, this is our last day as host.
Yeah.
Hump day.
Wait, David, that's all? Hump day!
Hump day! Mike! Mike! Mike!
Let's go.